One of Lorna Goodison's poems. Can you guess which of her poems? If you are able to do so, please state in the comment box below. Objectives. At the end of this presentation, the students will be able to 1. State the relevance or significance of the title of the poem, I Am Becoming My Mother. 2. Read the poem and analyze its content, looking specifically at the significant images and figures of speech. 3. State the various themes explored in the poem and examine closely the technique utilized by the poet. And last but definitely by no means least, 4. State some of the lessons that person may learn from this poem.
When you hear the title of this poem, I Am Becoming My Mother. Think about it for a minute. I am becoming my mother. If you are able to state clearly and expressively, or maybe not so clearly and expressively, what comes to your mind, please share it in the comment section below.
Envision someone who is displaying the same mannerism, attitude, or behavior as his or her mother, then you are on the right track. I am becoming my mother. Do I have the same mannerism? Do I display the same attitude? Do I have the same behavior as my mother?
Regarding the title, then you would have nailed it. Now that you understand the poem from a literal perspective, let us see how well we can grasp it from a figurative or metaphorical or symbolic perspective. What is the figurative interpretation of the title? According to blog journeyworks.com, Lorna Goodison's poem, I Am Becoming My Mother, is a beautiful, image-heavy, celebratory poem that describes how much the speaker has in common with her mother, how they share specific traits as well as a sense of belonging together in a powerful line of females. So we know that Lorna Goodison's poem will touch on areas such as womanhood, feminism, and of course, women in society, how women are treated in society. Of course, we know that some of her poems are deeply rooted in colonization, given the fact that she is a Caribbean writer, more specifically, a Jamaican writer. The use of the present continuous tense, am becoming, implies that the process is not completed. Hence, she may not be exactly like her mother in totality, right? So she is becoming. She exhibits the similar traits or attributes. However, she is not her mother in totality, not as yet. I am becoming. I am not yet. I appear to be like her. I display similar mannerism and everything, but she is not fully, okay, clothed in the same, what should I say, armor as the mother. She is not in totality like the mother, but she displays the same attitude, same mannerism, same characteristics or traits, okay? And so she is on the verge of being the mother. And so in this poem, as we explore the poem line by line, you will see the transformation of the child becoming like the mother, the woman. All right? So as you mature, you'll find that as children mature, they become more and more like their parents as they grow older. Being My Mother by Lorna Goodison. Yellow-brown woman, fingers smelling always of onions. My mother raises rare blooms and waters them with tea. Her birth water sprang like rivers. My mother is now me. My mother had a linen dress, the color of the sky, and store lace and damask tablecloths to pull shame out of her eye. I am becoming my mother, round yellow woman, fingers smelling always of onions. That was Lorna Goodison's poem, I Am Becoming My Mother. Okay, now that we have looked at Lorna Goodison's poem, I Am Becoming My Mother, let us now see how best we can analyze the poem lines by line, do a line by line analysis of the poem, or a stanza by stanza analysis of the poem. Okay, so as to pull from the poem, the figurative devices, the themes, and all the significant images that may stand out in the reader's mind. Let's explore the poem line by line. I am becoming my mother. Line 1 and line 2. Yellow/brown woman.
fingers smelling always of onions. Line 1. Yellow/brown woman gives us, the readers, a vivid picture of the woman's ethnicity. In this case, okay, it is apparent that she is neither white nor black, but is of mixed race. Hence the term yellow/brown woman. The use of the slash means or. Fingers smelling always of onions conveys the idea that she is always preoccupied with cooking, preparing meals, just like what the domesticated slaves would do or would have done. Are you seeing those images? Are you getting that from these lines?
Inspiration of this poem, we'll now turn to the second stanza. My mother raises rare blooms and waters them with tea. Her birth water sprang like rivers. My mother is now me. Let's look at the first line of this stanza. My mother raises rare blooms. This line gives the impression that the mother is a florist or gardener who takes care of her plants. But when we closely examine these lines, we get the impression that the poet is alluding to the mother's children. She raises rare blooms. It's suggestive of the fact that she raises children that are uniquely special, probably under very harsh conditions. Thus, they are rare. They are not typical, average, or common, similar to the children in For My Mother May I Inherit Her First Strength. They also are rare in the sense that their ethnicity is very different from the others around them. And this may convey the idea that they are mulattoes.
Let's continue to explore. And waters them with tea. The Caribbean people have used native plants and herbs to produce bush teas, having therapeutic properties and, of course, comforting taste for centuries. They have been doing it for years and years, because you know that a century is 100 years. Can you just imagine how many centuries they have been doing this for? Okay? The mere fact, however, that she waters them with tea is also suggestive of the delicate care and attention to details that she devotes to the raising of her offspring, thus causing them to bloom or to flourish. As in the poem For My Mother, May I Inherit Her First Strength, we are presented with a mother who devotes time, effort, and energy into the effective upbringing of her children. She's a selfless mother, wouldn't you say? Let me know if you share those thoughts, if you got that from the poem.
Water sang like rivers. This beautiful and interesting imagery and use of simile by Lorna Goodison paints a clear picture of childbirth, which of course is a laborious ordeal for most women. However, we get the impression that it was a rather calm, stressless, and soothing experience for the poet's mother. Perhaps the reason she has been gifted with 9 children. Sang like rivers. Rivers tend to lead or connect in that they are heading in the same direction. So before they go into the sea or ocean, right, they meet up, they connect, right? Thus the rivers, which represent the Caribbean region, is symbolic of the unity that exists among the Caribbean region, the Caribbean people, and to a greater extent, the unity that exists amongst the Caribbean women. Are you seeing that? I trust that you are seeing it. Okay, if you
agree or disagree with this interpretation of the river, you can let me know in the comment section below. What are your thoughts on the rivers? The rivers sang. Our birth waters sang like rivers. Sang like rivers.
This isn't very deep. My mother is Naomi. The use of the linking verb is very significant in this line. It conveys the idea that both mother and daughter are joined or linked. They have similar characteristics or traits or personalities. Basically, I am my mother and my mother is now me. I am a replica. It is also suggestive that as a child matures, she plays the role of the mother, caregiver, and nurturer. And as the mother matures, she plays the role of the child as she relegates to childlike mannerism and behaviors. Are you seeing that? Did you get that from that line? My mother is now me. Very deep. Are you in agreement with this interpretation?
Was very conscious. She was a very conscious woman. She was conscious of the fact that they were not wealthy. And this may have proved problematic for them as children because they might be subjected to being teased or taunted or be viewed as inferior. And so what she would do is that she would purchase and store fine things so that their condition or plight may not appear as devastating or depressing to pull shame out her eye. So the damask cloth, as you can see from the third panel, is a rich heavy silk or linen fabric with a pattern woven into it, used for table linen and of course upholstery. Right, so you will find these damask looking item or damask cloth used for chairs, sofas, etc. All right, good. And I'm sure you would have seen it before. Have you seen the damask cloth before? You seen anything looking like it before? If you have, let me know in the comment section below.
Yellow woman, fingers smelling always of onions. These lines are indicators of the completion of the cycle or the process. The daughter is becoming like the mother in terms of her disposition, activities, and responsibilities. The fact that Lorna Goodison uses repetition in this stanza emphasizes our message of unification of the women who are somewhat connected or share a bond based on their roles and their responsibilities. Are you able to see that? Did you get that impression of this stanza as well? Do you share similar thoughts on this? Let me know in the comment section below. I trust that this analysis of the lines have been useful or beneficial to you. Themes explored in this poem are as follows. 1. Women in society. 2. Colonization and post-colonization. 3. Feminism. 4. Traditional roles of women. 5. Parent-child relationship, more specifically mother-daughter relationship. And 6. Love and family relationship. If there are other themes that your teacher would have suggested, you can leave them in the comment section below.
Question 1. Which Caribbean
region is Lorna Goodison from? Is it A, Trinidad, B, Jamaica, C, Cuba, or D, Aruba? It uses all of the following devices except, is it A, alliteration, B, irony, C, simile, or D, repetition? Question 3 states, the title of the poem conveys the idea that the daughter exhibits the same mannerism and thus performs the same duties as her mother. Is it A, true, or B, false? Following line, her birth water sprang like rivers. Is it A, personification, B, metaphor, C, irony, or D, simile? Question 5 reads, this poem is about all of the following except. Is it A, a child who displays the same mannerism or traits as her parent or mother? B, the reversal of roles in the mother-daughter dynamics? C, the difficulties that children have accepting their parents and the influence they have to alter their course of life? Or D, the connectivity or bond that all women share globally? Is it A, true, or B, false? Answers to the given questions are as follows. Number 1, B. Number 2, B. Number 3, A. Number 4, D. Number 5, C. And number 6, A. How did you do? Did you get 6 out of 6? 5 out of 6? 4 out of 6? 3 out of 6? Please share in the comment section below. I trust you did very well on this activity, alright, and that you are more prepared now, that you fully grasp, fully understand this poem, I Am Becoming My Mother by Lorna Goodison. And please note that this poem can be compared to the poem For My Mother, May I Inherit Her Strength. May be compared with the poem, For My Mother, May I Inherit Half Her Strength. I trust that you have found all the information provided in this presentation beneficial. May God bless you. All the best. If you have found it to be beneficial, remember to like, share, tell a friend, and subscribe. God bless you. Oh.